Hey there guys, Paul here. In this video, I'm going to be walking you through some preferences, tools, and customizations to help you use the Coolselector 2 application like a pro. Coming up, changing the default units, viewing pressure enthalpy diagrams, overview of operating conditions, view product compatibility by refrigerants, general preferences, as well as advanced preferences to override default calculations and values. This video is part of a series where we'll be looking at a number of worked examples using the Coolselector 2 application to help you select and calculate components for your refrigeration system. So do check out the other videos if you haven't already, links are in the video description below. If you would like to change your default units displayed within the application, simply select Options, then Units, and then select the units required. Additionally, you can create custom units to suit specific projects or clients and save this as a custom unit for future use. This is achieved by clicking Options, Units, and then Custom. A window will then pop up showing you the different units available. Once you have made a change, you can save this as a custom unit option using the Name Unit Set input on the right-hand side and then clicking the Add Unit Set button. This will then show in the list. If we then click on Options and then Units, you will see the new custom unit is shown in the menu. You can view pressure enthalpy diagrams for refrigerants within Coolselector 2. There are two ways to do this. The first way is to click on Tools in the top menu bar and then select logp-h diagrams. A new window will then pop up with the choice of refrigerants listed on the left-hand side. If we then click, for example, R404A, the window now refreshes to display the pressure enthalpy diagram for this refrigerant. Along the bottom, we have a number of important thermodynamic properties. The values in these change in real time as we move our mouse across the diagram. Along the top, we also have a number of options to allow us to export the diagram. The second way we can access this is during a product selection. If, for example, we select a compressor, we can view the thermodynamic data and a system schematic in the Performance Detail tab along the bottom. Within the system schematic, you will notice a button titled Detailed Log pH Diagram. If we click this, then a new window will pop up showing us the pressure enthalpy diagram with the product performance overlaid. By moving and resizing the window, we can view the points on the schematic as well as the performance table. You can view all the operating conditions for a system and component by clicking on Tools in the top main menu bar and then selecting Show Operating Conditions Overview. A pop-up window will then appear listing all the operating conditions for the system. Each parameter has been converted into the relevant alternative units such as American, International and SI. The pop-up window will float above the Coolselector 2 application window and can be moved around by clicking and dragging the pop-up. If you make changes to your operating conditions, the pop-up will update the information shown. Additionally, if you move to another product selection tab, the information displayed will change to suit that product and system. If you would like to see which Danfoss products are available for a specific refrigerant, you can view Products and Refrigerants Overview by clicking on Tools located in the top menu bar and then selecting Products and Refrigerants Overview. A pop-up will then appear displaying a scrollable table. On the left, we have the product type and family, and along the top, we have each refrigerant. We can scroll across to find the refrigerant we're working with, and then scroll down to find compatible products. The color of the cells indicates which products are approved for this refrigerant. Green cells represent an approved product. Yellow represents a product for which Coolselector 2 performs the calculations. However, you need to consult Danfoss or your supplier to check the compatibility with your system. Grey cells represent products which are not approved or compatible with a refrigerant, and Coolselector 2 does not perform any calculations for them. At the bottom of the pop-up, we also have the option to export this data to Excel. If you're mostly working on commercial or industrial projects, you can reduce the number of products and options displayed on the user interface by clicking Options in the top main menu bar and then clicking Preferences, and then selecting either industrial or commercial. You can further customize these by clicking Options, Preferences, and then selecting Edit Preferences. If we switch between commercial and industrial, we see the default system changes as well as the product pages. We can show or hide the product's pages using the checkboxes and also change their display order using the up and down arrows. Additionally, you can also change the default system at the top of the window by selecting the System Title Radio button. If we then move to the Valve and Line Components tab at the top of the window, we can include and exclude different product categories by selecting or unselecting the checkbox next to their title. Sub-product categories can also be included or excluded by clicking on the plus buttons to expand the list. We also have the option to include or exclude products based on the connection type as well as their materials. These can be added or removed by clicking the check buttons. If we head to the Compressors and Condenser Units tab at the top of the window, we then have the option to alter the match tolerance for the selection limits. We can include or exclude products based on their performance rating by clicking on the Compressor or Condensing Unit Rating button and selecting or unselecting the options. We can also include or exclude products according to their application and product type within the tabs for compressors and condensing units. Once you are happy with your changes, just click the OK button. You will then be prompted to save this as a new custom preference. To do this, just click Yes and it will ask you to name the preference. If we then head to Options and Preferences, our custom preference will be displayed on the list. We can switch to a different preference by simply clicking the preference title. The next part we'll look at is the ability to change the default values for calculations. This is not recommended and you should be extra cautious to make changes here. Changes to this section can have negative effects on suggestions and calculations. If you do make changes, you'll be prompted to save this as a custom preference. Before moving onto an unassociated project, ensure you change this back to a default preference. To do this, select Options, Preferences, and then click on Edit Preferences. This will launch a new pop-up window. To change the calculation values, click on the Valves and Line Components tab and then click Advanced. A number of tabs will now display, giving us the ability to modify the advanced defaults. Under the Default Values tab, you can adjust the valve opening degree and loading percentage used for the selection criteria. You can also change the default pipe lengths and material roughness, as well as some miscellaneous defaults such as isentropic efficiency, compressor heat loss, and Reynolds numbers for laminar and turbulent flows, which would affect pressure drop calculations. Under the Calculations Limit tab, you can change the temperature limits as well as warnings for both temperature and velocity. Under the Selection Criteria tab, you can change how a product suggestion is matched by clicking on the table cells and choosing from the drop-down menu that appears. You can also change the default velocities and saturation temperature drops using the sub-tabs. Under the Additional tab, we have the options to automatically add reducers and expanders. Once you're satisfied with your changes, you can save this as a custom preference by clicking the OK button. A new window will now pop up, prompting you to save this preference. Just enter a name and click OK to save this. If we then click on Options and Preferences, we'll see this new preference listed. We can re-edit preferences, other than the defaults, by clicking Options, Preferences, Edit Preferences. Here we also have the option on the right-hand side to rename or delete a custom preference. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. We hope you've enjoyed this and it has helped you. If so, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. If you have any questions at all, let us know in the comment section down below. You can also find links to more Coolselector tutorials in the video description. Do check those out. And once again, thanks for watching.